Now under inverse interpolation, we will find the roots of an algebraic equation by inverse interpolation. Suppose that a real root of fx which is equal to 0 has been isolated. Then fx may be tabulated using a finite interval in the neighborhood of the root and represented closely by a central difference formula. This produces a polynomial equation in which the terms of higher degree have very small influence. Consequently, an accurate approximation to the required root can be found, and this approximation can be improved by an iterative procedure. Now, this can be easily understood by this example. Suppose we take an example. Find the method of inverse interpolation, the real root of the equation x cube minus x minus 3 is equal to 0, which lies between 1.2 and 1.3. So first of all, we will draw difference table. So x, when x is equal to 1, capital X is equal to 0.2, and y, which is equal to x cube plus x minus 3, which is minus 1. So corresponding value 1.1 of x, capital X is 0.1 and y is minus 0.569. When x is equal to 1.2, capital X is equal to 0, y is 0.072. When x is equal to 1.3, capital X is equal to 0.1 and y is equal to plus 0.497. And when x is equal to 1.4, capital X is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1.144. So first of all, we will calculate del y. Del y will be 0.431, 0.497, 0.569 and 0.647. Del 2y will be 0.066, 0.072 and 0.078. Del 3y will be 0.006 and 0.006, and del 4y will be equal to 0. The root of the equation is 1.2 plus 0.1 x0, where we have to find the value of x0. Taking the origin at 1.2, interval of difference is 0.1, and using Stirling formula, we can say that y is equal to y0 plus x into delta y0 delta y minus 1 upon 2 plus x square upon 2 del 2 y1 del 2 y minus 1 plus x into x square minus 1 upon 6 del 3 y minus 1 plus del 3 y minus 2 upon 2. So we get 0 is equal to minus 0.072 plus x into 0.569 plus 0.497 upon 2 plus x square upon 2 into 0.072 plus x into x square minus 1 upon 3, 0.006. So this will be equal to minus 0.072 plus 0.531x plus 0.003336x square plus 0.002x cube. This cubic equation can be solved by successive approximation. So equation number 1 can also be written as x equal to 0.072 upon 0.531 minus 0.0036 upon 0.531 x square minus 0.001 upon 0.531 x cube. Now first approximation of x will be x1 is equal to 0.072 upon 0.531, which is equal to 0.1353. Second approximation, substitute the value of x in equation number 1, we get x2, and x2 will be 0.1353 minus 0.067 into 0.1353 ka whole square minus 0.001 upon 0.531 into 0.1353 ka whole cube, and on solving we get the value of x2 is 0.134 approximately. So real root will be 1.2 plus 0.1 into 1.34, which is equal to 1.2134. Now take another example, example number 5. Example number 4 is simple, you can do it yourself. Now suppose solve the equation x is equal to 10 log 10x, where data is given as x 1.35, 1.36, 1.38, and log x will be 0.1303, 0.1335, 0.1365, 0.1367, and 0.1399. So the difference table will be x and y are given in the tabular form. So delta y will be 0.032, 0.032, and 0.032. So delta y will be zeros. So we find that all differences above the first are zero. Now take x0 is equal to 1.37, because x and 10 log 10x are nearest to each other for this value of x, h is equal to 0.01. So by Stirling formula, we can see that y is equal to y0 plus x into delta y0 plus delta y minus 1 upon 2, and so on. So we can say that 1.37 is equal to 1.367 plus x into 0.032 plus 0.032 upon 2. So this will give x the value as 0.136. So required root will be x0 plus hx, which is 1.37 plus 0.01 into 0.136, which is equal to 1.37136. That's all.